In this video, we are going to learn how to make custom stickers for your helmets, like this one. If it's your first time here, this is the Bk42 channel, and this channel is all about custom bikes. So, if this is your thing, make sure you hit the subscribe and the notification bell, so you don't miss out. Let's start it. If you don't have the Adobe Illustrator yet, you can download the trial version on adobe.com. All links will be in the description below. So let's open up the Adobe Illustrator. Here we are. Then we need to go to the menu File, New to create a new document. Let's name it Helmet Art. And OK, no changes are needed here. I can add rules or just add a placeholder with the helmet size. You can just use the square tool or press the key M and click anywhere. The units are not correct. We need it in centimeters, not pixels. So cancel, Command K to open the preferences, units, and let's set the general at centimeters. OK, so once again, M, click anywhere, and 14 by 13. OK, centralize the square to make the things easier. I can use the moving tool or just press the key V. To make it easier, I will lock this layer. Let's go to the layer tab, lock this layer, click in here, and add a new one. Let's name it as Art. Double click in the name and rename it. We cannot touch the square anymore. Alright, so we are good to start our design. If you don't see the layers or any kind of tab, you should go to the menu window and activate anyone you need, like layers or text or aligning. Any tab you need will be here. Alright, let's start designing our text. For that, just press the key T and start typing. D. I want to have four different texts here, so ask. T again, ask, T again, ask. I get all text here, so let's make it bigger so and it will be easier to work with. Remember to keep the key Shift pressed to maintain the proportions, like this. The size is good, and now let's change the font type. Press Command plus T to open the fonts window, and let's search for the font. I would like to use the font Vintage Party, this one. You can download this font for free for your personal projects on 1001freefonts.com. All links will be in the description below. Alright, so now we got the font. I'm not going to change anything else. It's all good, so select all of them. You can just click anywhere and drag, or just press Command A, and it's all selected. Go to the menu object, expand, OK. All right, so now we have the outlines, and you are not going to change anything else. I would like to have the fonts like following the helmet shape. So for that, I will select the first one, go to Effect, Warp, Arc. Let's set the bend as 26%. Or 27%. Okay, so object, expand appearance. So now go to window, the menu window, Pathfinder, and use this small icon here. All right, so now we have one element. Let's do the same thing with the others. Highway, I want a highway to be a bit bigger. Keep shift all the time. Menu effect, warp, arc. But instead of 27, we're gonna keep it like 16 is fine. Okay, menu object, expand appearance. Okay, the D is still too big. Let's keep shift and make it smaller because I would like to have here. Keep this one outside, I don't need it for now. Hell, I would like to have it bigger, much bigger. Shift and effect, warp, arc. 31% is good. Apply, object, expand appearance. Okay, here we are. The last one. So we need just a small effect here. Warp, arc, 9%. Okay, object, expand appearance, and merge. That's all. Let's make it smaller. Shift. If you press the key R, you can rotate. I want to rotate a bit this one. Okay, double click the TO. So now we are working only in this element. Press A and select the dot, those dots. Now we can change the font, you see? Okay, that's what I need. Let me just check. Command Y. You see here we have different elements. I need to group all of them. Select this word and merge. Command Y to return. What we have to do, we are almost there, is duplicate all of them. So select all of them, Command G, Command C, and Command V twice. One to the right, the second to the left. Okay, now we have three of them. Select the center one, go to the color bar, use any color you like. I'm going to use the blue. Okay, and copy the blue color to the stroke line here. Now we need to go to window, menu window, and open the stroke windows. If you see like this, we need to see more properties here. So show options. Let's set it 0.7. And let's change the cap and the corner. All right, there we are. So object, again, expand and merge. Now select the right one, the second one. Open the color picker. And let's make it white. Create the stroke. And let's set it to 0.4. Cap and corner, again, central. Yeah, that's good, exactly. So object, expand, and merge. We can select the white one, right click, arrange, bring to front. Select the first one, arrange, bring it to front. Select both of them in Pathfinder tab. Use this icon to slice, to split them. Now, right click and ungroup. Click in the white element, go to the menu, select, same, fill and stroke. So what it is doing is selecting all white elements in this art. Now it's all selected, just delete it. There are some small blue parts here, we don't need it. It's going to be a problem for cutting. So we can remove them, Command Y, press A and select like this one or this one. Yeah, we are good to go. So now select the blue, go to the menu select, same, fill color. All right, Command G, try to select all blue, press Shift and click in the blue color, delete. We are good now. Now select all of them, align, center, center. Now bring it to the center just to check the size. We can make it a bit bigger. We have some room here. That's okay. Click and select the blue one. Press the key I, click on the black item to pick the same color. All right, our art is done. What do we have to do now? To avoid any problems, let's save it as EPS. So go to the menu file, save as, choose where you want to save it. I'm going to the desktop. Helmet art is there. In the format, change it to Illustrator EPS. Save it. Let's use an older version to avoid some compatibility issues. Illustrator 10. Okay, save it. So now what we have to do is send it to the printer house. I'm going to show you later the results. The link to download this file will be in the description below. You can use it as you like. Well, I'm back, and this is the sticker sheet. As you can see, it's possible to make more than one sticker, paying for the minimum slicing price. Let's cut our art out of the sheet. I'm going to accelerate it a little bit. Before peeling the transfer paper, check if it fits once again. We need to prepare the helmet to apply the sticker. Remove all dust and grease from it. Well, it's clean now. Ensure that all art is transferred to the transfer paper. Carefully remove the transfer paper. Thank you. Here we are, our work is done. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Cheers!